So now let's move forward. Okay, let's see how to do the problem. Okay, let's come back to problem. This is a problem. Design a four-bar mechanism to coordinate the positions of coupler point. There are three polar coordinates given, and we have seen what is path generation technique up to some extent. That's not complete, but that's just enough to understand whatever I'm going to teach further. Okay, I'm going to discuss. They have given angular displacements of input links. Let's just keep these in mind because we are going to do and we come across these values often. I may not use the term R1 alpha 1 again and again. So see, R1 is 55, alpha 1 is 75, R2 is 70, alpha 2 is 50, R3 is 75, alpha 3 is 40, theta 1 2 is 30, theta 1 3 is 70. Okay, now let's see, we have to draw this. This is the origin. Okay, this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, and this is the origin. From origin, first point is at a distance of 55 millimeter at an angle of 75 degrees. R1 is 55, alpha 1 is 75. Similarly, we have to locate E2 and E3 also. We have located it. After this, we have to choose a point A somewhere, anywhere. This is O. This is O. See, X, Y, this is the origin. Here, what we have done is we have deleted all the other things. We have taken A, a point A. This is the point we can choose. We can choose anywhere. Anywhere we can choose according to our comfort and our convenience. We can choose A anywhere. So we have origin is here. We have removed all the things related to origin. We have chosen A. Now only this point matters to us. Before all, whatever is there, we have to forget. We can forget. We don't need those again. Okay, from A, we have to join AE1, AE2, AE3. Now, A is what? A is the first point of fixed link. Leftward point of fixed link, to be precise. We have chosen A. Then what we have done? We have rotated E2 by an angle of 30 degrees, theta 1 2. You know why we rotated this? We have seen it. We have seen it, right? We have fixed this and we have rotated it theta 1 2 in clockwise direction. But in this problem, E1, E2, E3 are in this direction, in this sense. E1, E2, E3 are in this sense. That means crank was rotating anti-clockwise. But for our present problem, crank is rotating in clockwise direction. E1, E2, E3. This is not crank. This is E1 is coupler point. But we can assume that because E1 rotates in the direction crank rotates. This is common sense, like common basic knowledge. Okay. So E1, E2, E3 are given. So theta 1 2 is given as 30 degrees. So we have rotated E2 by 30 degrees. We get E2 dash. Similarly, we have rotated E3 by 70 degrees. We get E3 dash. From these three, we have seen we have joined E1, E2, E3. From this, I have to explain. Now we know why we have rotated, because we have fixed the link B. We want to find B1, that is discussed earlier. So we have know we now know why we rotated this cranks. Now let us try to find B1. What is B1 again? The position of other point of input link. Input link point. One point is common for both fixed link and input link. This point is common for the hinge joint or the rotating joint, rotating point of the input link and coupler. दिस इज अ पॉइंट बी वन. हाउ टू फाइंड बी वन अगेन, बी बी इज कॉन्स्टेंट, बी इज ए लिंक डिस्टेंस. ओके सो बी ई, सो बी वन ई वन इक्वल टू बी टू ई टू इक्वल टू बी थ्री ई थ्री. नाउ वी नो द रिलेशन, वी नो दैट ई बी इज इक्वी डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम ई वन ई टू, ई वन ई टू डैश एंड ई थ्री डैश. बट हाउ टू फाइंड इट, वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग ऑफ परपेंडिकुलर बाइसेक्टर. Now, what is a perpendicular bisector? A line passing through midpoint, joining two ends of a line segment, and that the line is perpendicular to the line joining two points. Again, what is a perpendicular bisector or mid normal? You can call it both perpendicular bisector or mid normal. It is a line which passes through midpoint of a line segment and it is perpendicular to it. So this is definition, like we can understand how it looks. But what is the meaning of perpendicular bisector? You take any point on this perpendicular bisector, you draw a line, this join this that point with two ends of the line segment, like E1 and E2 dash. What you will notice, it both the lengths will be of equal length. Why? Because perpendicular bisector is the same. But we know that from center, distance of any two points on the circle is same. So what can we conclude from this? We can say this is center and these two are points on the circle. Now again, if we can say that all these points are like that only. So all the points are locus of centers of circle passing through points E2 and E2 dash and E1. Okay, now where we are defining the perpendicular bisector. So from this point, this distance and this distance are equal. So from this point, we are searching for a point which is equidistant from E1 and E2. We are seeing that only, right? B is at equidistance from E1 and E2 because BE and BE2 and BE3 all are of same equal lengths. So the B1 lies on this line because BE equal to BE2 dash. So BE lies on this line. But again, this is one set, and again you can see one more. E1, E3 also equidistant from B1. So B will should also lie on perpendicular bisector of E1, E3 dash. So B will be lying on this line also. So if you no need to draw this red color third perpendicular bisector, I just want to show that all will coincide at one point only, so that length of B1 E3, B1 E2 dash, B1 E1 will be same. That's why in drawing, while drawing, you need not draw red color this perpendicular bisector for E2 dash, E3 dash. Okay, we found B1, that's all. Now we know A1, B1, E1. A1, B1, E1 is our first, A1, B1 is fixed link, input link, and B1, E1 is the link of the coupler. Above one triangle is there, but in our problem it seems it's below. It will come like this, triangle will be below. Let's see it later, but now you can say B1 E1 is a link of the triangle we saw above. Okay, now let's proceed. Now we found B1 E1, we have joined that, we have backgrounded this all the other things so that you can have clear view of what we are going to do now. Okay, B1 E1 is found, but how to find b2? What is point b2? B2 again. Now we know b1 is the position of fixed link, sorry, position of input link at first position. Like b1 is the coordinates of input link, a1 b1 is input link at position 1. So we know position 1 thing, we know position 1. How to find position 2? We are given theta 1 2 equal to 30 degrees. So what is theta 1 2 again? Theta 1 2 is angle between second position of input link and first position of input link. So this is theta 1 2. Theta 1 2 is 30. So how to find b2? It's simple, you have to rotate this by 30 degrees. In paper, while you are drawing, you take this as base reference line and you draw a 30 degrees line like this, and you have to take same radius from A. You cut an arc of radius A B1 and you will get B2. How to find B3? Again, with reference to this line, you draw 70 degrees and with the same radius AB1 you cut an arc, you will find B3. E2 and E3 are before only you have marked them, you don't erase that while doing, and you join those two. Now you get AB1 E1, AB2 E2, AB3 E3. Now comes the another part. It's not possible for me to go through this in depth, but using inversion only you can prove that E2 B2 D1 and E1 B1 D2, these two triangles will be congruent. You can prove that. If possible, I'll make a video on that. Okay, I will add in the description if time permits. I have other works. So E1 B1 D2, E1 B1 D2 is congruent triangle with E2 B2 D1, and similarly E3 B3 D1 is similar to E1 B1 D3. These two triangles are similar. So how can you use that? First you have to assume a location for D1. What is D1 again? D1 is a other point of fixed link, second point of fixed link, or you can say the common point for fixed link and driven crank. So you will take some position of D1, you join B2 D1, E2 D1 and B3 D1, E3 D1. Now you know the distances B3 D1. With a compass you take measurement of this B3 D1 and you keep compass at B1 and you draw an arc of length B3 D1. You get draw an arc here and with E3 as center and this radius E3 D1 radius and E1 as center, you draw another arc, you will find D3. Join these three, you will get point D3. And similarly with B2 as center, you measure B2 D1 and with B1 as center and B2 D1 as radius, draw an arc, and with E2 as center and E2 D1 as radius, draw another arc and you will get D2 point. Now join D3, D2 and D1. All three points are at equidistance from which point? C. C is the point on the coupler, like the common point of coupler and driven crank. So you will get the meeting of perpendicular bisectors of D3, D2 and D1, D2 is C. This point is C. Now you got A, B1, E1, C and D1. This is first position. First position of the four bar mechanism we were searching for. This is it, and now you have successfully completed this. If you want to draw other positions, you know all the lengths A1, B1, C1, D1 and E1. With this lengths you can draw it anywhere. For example, if you want to draw AB2 C2 D2, AB2 you have to draw this line, and you know B1 C1 length, and E1 you have E2 also you have to draw, and with B1 C1 and E1 C1 length you can find C2, and you know AD1 length and CD1 length. From that you can find D2 and others also. Now let's see how it works in AutoCAD. Let's see how the mechanism runs. Like visually I'll explain how the model works.